However, we have to realize that physics, which is the science of understanding and explaining our physical world, the mother of all science, the supreme classical science is physics, has limits that they are not, they never have been well defined. And we have several examples of physical problems that became physical recently. Case in point. The ancient world was thinking that the planet was flat. And that given the time, if you were traveling along the planet, you're going to fall off to a place where huge monsters wait to eat you up. Now, I mean, how many people nowadays, if you tell them that the Earth is flat, will agree with you? Let's not forget that when Christopher Columbus in the 14th century was about 15th, was about ready to start his westward trip to discover East India, because that was the idea. Many of the wise people of Spain, many of the scientists of the time, they were telling him that he's going to fall off the planet. Okay, so we're talking about 15th century. Anyway, soon after his trip, people start thinking quite differently. But if you go through the books of many ancient civilizations, you will discover that the belief of people that the planet was flat was very strong. Incidentally, there are many accounts that I am referring to in the book. So, what I'm trying to say here is that what is extremely physical right now, which is the realization that our planet is round, up to that particular point of time, was metaphysical. It was a matter of ideas, of how people can conceive it, how can understand it. Another very important question that used to be metaphysical and became physical is the fact that the center of the universe, the center of our understanding of our planetary system, is the Sun. The ancients were believing that the center was the planet Earth, and all the other stars were revolving around the Earth. How many people nowadays will seriously assume that such a thing is really truth? But at the time, that was the truth. So the question of whether our universe is heliocentric or based center on the Earth became physical only in the 16th century. After Christ. Okay, so you see that the boundaries between metaphysics and physics, which is science, they are always moving. Another good example of this kind of thing is the fact that the theories of Einstein. They are much less physical than anything else. Yet nowadays, we consider them absolutely physical. They were purely theories, that they were based on cognitive understanding, and recently we are just proving their reality. Only recently. The quantum theory is the least scientific theory that exists, yet is the foundation of all our science nowadays. So you see that people should not really say, oh, metaphysics, science, yeah. These two legs are in continuous communication and one feeds the other. As a matter of fact, I will not hesitate to state that whatever we consider physical was the metaphysics of yesterday. Physical is the part of the metaphysics that went through the process and it is well accepted now as physical. A cognitive process. Accepted. So we came to a certain point of realizing certain things and therefore we do not react against them. And therefore they became physical. I will close this paragraph with the observation that metaphysics indeed is everything. Physics, as we said, is the part of metaphysics that now we accept. But metaphysics is of utmost importance because it does not only explain what happens beyond our senses, beyond our physical world, but most importantly, explain how the physical world was created. Something that the physical world cannot claim yet. So metaphysics is able to explain not only what happens beyond our senses, but also how the physical world works, which makes it very, very interesting. Thank you.